Hi, I'm Jon Lemon. I'm a live sound engineer. I'm a studio engineer. I've been at it for a long time, so it goes back a fair while. I've worked with acts like Level 42, The Cure, Depeche Mode, then more recently, you know, Nine Inch Nails, Ray LaMontagne, Beck, Lana Del Rey, and I'm currently on tour with Sia. It came about sort of by accident, because when I was about 13 years old, my parents wouldn't let me stay at home one night and forced my sister to take me to the nightclub that she worked at the local YMCA. And I got there early and had nothing to do and noticed these guys loading in a very primitive PA, and I offered, you know, can I give you a hand? Because it was a giant steel staircase. And goes, yeah, please. Little did I know I was just working for nothing. But he happened to be a professor of electronics at Adelaide University, and he was a teacher, so he taught me, you know, this is how we wire it up and this is how we put mics together, I think all four of them. And then the band came and did a sound check, and I'd never seen anything like it before, and I kind of knew then this is for me. So I kept going back every weekend and working for this guy, Trevor Marshall, and that's when it started. And that was kind of probably early 70s, I think, so quite primitive, but it sucked me in, and that's what started my whole passion for audio and music, really. I was a really bad bass player when I was a teenager, and I had a car that I could fit the PA into in Adelaide, so I always got that job, and I just enjoyed it more. So I was just all thumbs, no fingers and elegance. So I had musical background, but really the production of music, both live and recording-wise, was what I wanted to chase. When I was 17 or 18, and I'd been doing, you know, on and off on weekends, just working around Adelaide for extra money for this guy, Trevor Marshall at Trevmar Sound, and I left Adelaide. I was either going to go to university and do law school or just go and work with bands in Sydney and Melbourne, which were the big cities of Australia. And somehow I made my way to, you know, work up and down the east coast of Australia with a couple of different bands and got paid well for it. Did that for a couple of years. And when I was about 21 or so, I got a job at Jans, which was the big international sound company of Australia, did all the big international acts. And right then and there, sort of luckily, I was taken under the wing of by a guy called Howard Page, who's a legend in the live field, now with Clare Brothers, mixes Sting. And he taught me about being a front of house tech and really how to mix. And consequently, I did that for a number of years, probably 6 years or so, and worked for a lot of the big Australian bands then, because I was exposed to the bigger touring world. So it was great, you know. The big turning point in my career really in Australia was when John Williams and the band Sky asked me to move to the UK back in 1984. And I'd already worked for a lot of international UK acts like, you know, Leo Sayer, many, many acts actually, a lot of American acts as well. So I knew a lot of, you know, live crew from different sound companies in England. And I thought I was going to go there for a 6 week tour with Sky. And 2 days before I went, my wife and I decided we're going to move to England and see what happens. And I did that tour. And then I did some pretty tough running around, fifth man on the PA crew, all the sort of crap work you do. And I think in 1985, I fell into a position where I was asked by a band called Level 42 to do their front of house while they were in the middle of doing a run of 24 shows at Wembley Arena. So I was sort of thrown in at the deep end. And really, I never looked back from there. That was such a big highlight for me. I worked for them for about 6 or 7 years, and then going through the 80s, I got to, you know, the end of the 80s, I got to work for Sinead O'Connor, the Pet Shop Boys, The Cure, Depeche Mode, quite a few American acts at that time as well by the 90s. And I think, you know, the really big highlight, so that was a big highlight, Level 42, but then things happened to me, like in 2008, I got asked to do the Pink Floyd reunion for Live 8 along with Andy Jackson. And you can't get sort of more of a highlight than that in reality, just to stand in front of the original band in rehearsal rooms and then on at Hyde Park on that day. And it was just one of the most amazing moments in my life, really. As far as artists and music go, I think it was more producers, actually, because George Martin, number one, I was just such a Beatles fan and I found out about him. And then in the 70s, I always loved prog rock, so Yes were a big band for me. And then the American sort of influence of the Eagles was recording Heaven to me. And Vocal Heaven. So they were some of the bands that started it. And Trevor Horn as well, coming a little sort of closer to the 80s, blew me away. All that nightclubbing stuff with Grace Jones and then the Yes stuff. They were big influences on me, but ultimately George Martin. I think in the 80s, going into the 90s, Flood and in particular Alan Moulder as an engineer really affected me and brought me into that. That was around the time, actually, I was doing Depeche Mode. I did a run of bands. They did Depeche Mode, The Smashing Pumpkins, some other stuff I can't remember, but Alan Moulder, the sound he got on My Bloody Valentine's record, I was just so blown out. I thought, I've got to try and reproduce that live in particular. I hadn't been doing that much studio stuff at that time, you know, a few live albums, but not that many. I feel privileged and lucky to have had that experience and have grown up with the analog world, now into the digital world.